protect Social Security from privatization. I oppose privatization 100%. I also believe, and I know there may be one or two of you here on Social Security in this room, you did not get a COLA increase last year. And the reason that you didn't get a COLA increase is because the government mandates that we use a consumer price index called CPIW in determining whether or not you're going to get an increase for Social Security. CPIW is urban wage earners. Essentially what they do is they go out and they do surveys to determine what the amount of money it costs to live in a certain area, and that's what they use to determine whether or not you get a COLA or cost of living increase. There's another CPI that's been developed in recent years called CPIE, and it essentially stands for Consumer Price Index Elderly, and it takes greater account the cost that people who are on Social Security face, which is increased medical costs. And so I would support, and I will introduce a bill in the Congress to change the CPI that's used from CPIW to CPIE, which will then help Social Security recipients get have a cost of living increase every year. It's something that I promised I would do for my mom, who calls me every time she doesn't get an increase. It says, you know, it's all Obama's fault. I say it's not Obama's fault. It's really Congress's fault.
Scrap the cap.
I am not in favor of scrapping the cap.
Raise the cap.
Raise the cap. Use the donut hole for the cap. Let me address that. You know how Social Security works. Current workers pay into the system, and then that money is then given to recipients. Any excess money is put into what they call a trust fund account. You hear politicians talk about all the time how Social Security is going to go broke. Social Security will never go broke as long as you have workers working, because workers are paying the current recipients. What will happen is, if there aren't enough workers paying to pay for the cost of Social Security, that's when Social Security benefits will have to be cut. The reason why they don't get cut now, even though that's occurring, there aren't enough workers to pay the Social Security benefits, is because they take that money from the trust fund, and they use that trust fund money to supplement the cost of paying everybody's benefits 100%. And so you'll hear politicians say, oh, Social Security is going to go broke in 2035. That's not really going to happen. What's going to happen is the trust fund is going to be depleted. Now, how do we fix that problem? There's a couple of different solutions. The first solution that was mentioned by Larry is to scrap the cap. Currently, you pay 6.2% of Social Security tax on the first $118,500 that you make in a year. If you're a billionaire, if you make $1 billion a year, you only pay 6.2% on the first $118,500 that you make, which is probably in the first 5 minutes of that particular year. A lot of people think that that's unfair. I think it's unfair too. However, I am not willing to scrap the cap completely, because I think that would hurt middle class folks. I think a better solution is to have what they call a donut hole, so that people pay the first 6.2% on $118,000, and then they pay again at the $500,000 mark, or at the $250,000 mark, so that it doesn't completely fall on people who make more than $118,000. If we were to do that, that would fix the issue with the trust fund. Again, I think we need to send people to Washington, or we're going to have the courage to stand up and do that. Social Security is a great program, and it's never going to go away. It's just a question of when the Congress gets around to fixing it. And again, I completely and unequivocally oppose privatization. I think that's a huge mistake.